Hi, hello, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's been a hot minute since I've been here. I've been really busy with school and stuff, so yeah, I haven't really been making videos lately, but I figured I'd hop on and do one last video of 2021 and talk about all my favorite books that I read this year, which, I mean, what better time to do it than New Year's Eve? So yeah, so I had a really good reading year this year. This is the first year that I've actually counted how many books I've read, because normally I don't keep track, but I was using Goodreads, so kept track this year. I read 63 books, which I'm super happy about. So I don't have anything just to compare it to. I feel like I read a lot more this year, but I don't know. But yeah, there are some really awesome books in here, and there are a lot, so I'm not going to talk about like any of them in too much detail. I'm just kind of going to go through and say what books were my favorites. So the first one is Thomas King's Indians on Vacation. This book was so good. It was such a treat to read. I think it came out this year. I could be wrong. Maybe it came out in 2020. But yeah, it was really great. Classic King writing. Really funny. Also had some pretty sad moments in it too, but I feel like Thomas King is like the master of balancing like tragedy and trauma with humor. So yeah, this was just another great one from him. The next one on my list is Take a Hint, Dani Brown. This is a romance, and I really loved all of Talia Hibbert's books of hers that I read this year. She was a new author that I just found out about this year, so that was really fun. This was my favorite out of the series. Love it. If you're looking for some saucy romances, this is definitely one of those. Okay, the next book is Norwegian Wood, and this was so good. Again, apologies to my friend for roasting her for liking this book. I have to admit, the title does kind of make it sound like it's gonna be porn, but it's not, and apparently it's a reference to a Beatles song, which I actually didn't realize until after I read it. But yeah, this is just such an amazing book. If you love writing and love literature, you will love this. The next one was such a surprise to me when I read it, but it's Before the Coffee Gets Cold. And I'll have like all of the books, like not linked, but just listed down below. Like if you want to look up the authors or end up checking them out yourselves. But this seriously was one of the most unique books I think I've ever read. I think it's gonna become an all-time favorite for me. It's nice and short, which is great, but the premise is just so unique and so interesting, and the writing is beautiful. I've never seen anything like it. It reminds me actually a little bit of Norwegian Wood in writing style. But yeah, this story was just amazing, and it's broken up into kind of like five or six like different sections that focus on different characters, but it's so good. And like two of the sections even made me cry, which is like a big thing because I normally don't get emotional while reading books, but this book really tugged on my heartstrings. So 100%, this was maybe in my top five books that I read this year. The next one was, again, also one of my top few favorites, and that is Daisy Jones and the Six. Oh my god, I loved this book so much. It was such a fun read and such an interesting format too, like because it's written in sort of an interview style, which can be so hilarious sometimes because you have two people like talking about the same event and it goes differently like according to different perspectives. But yeah, it's really awesome, and the book is inspired by Fleetwood Mac and kind of like the Rumours era, which is like they're one of my favorite bands, so it was really fun to read. And actually, when I was first reading it, I didn't know for sure that like it was inspired by that, but the whole time I was just thinking of Fleetwood Mac, and then like in the acknowledgements like it does say, so I'm like, oh okay, that makes a lot more sense. But and I heard that they're making this into a TV show, which I am so excited for. But yeah, this was maybe the favorite book I read this year. I don't know. There were a lot of really great ones, but I loved this. And if you love music, you should check this out. Okay, the next book I read, I think, was actually the first book I read this year. And it was 5 out of 5, such a knockout. And that is Such a Fun Age. I loved the writing style of this book. And I think it was still cute and wholesome, but tackled like a lot of like really important topics. And it just, the writing in it, I'm like, if I could write half as good as this, like, that would be amazing. That would be my dream come true, because these are just the kind of books that I want to write. And yeah, it was just such a treat to read. Love contemporary novels. So yeah, this was an easy spot in my favorite books this year. The next one on my list was another kind of out of left field one, and that is The Death of Vivek OG. And I was so shocked by this book, because I was originally, when I started reading it, I was having like a slump, so I was like, okay, just like sit down, read 50 pages, like then you'll be good. I was trying to force myself to read, and I ended up reading this in one sitting because it was just so captivating that I couldn't put it down and page turning. And yeah, it's just a really interesting book and one of the most unique ones I've read this year. And I don't think that it would be for everyone, but I think that it's a very interesting one to read. I don't know how to describe it without like giving stuff away, but if you love books, you should definitely check this out, because it was a wild ride for sure. Kept me on my toes. All right, the next one I have here is The Invisible Life of Addie, Larue. And it was funny because I heard such mixed reviews on this book. I know that a lot of like big V Schwab fans didn't like it because it's pretty different to her other books, but I loved it. I mean, it wasn't without its issues, but I just love the writing of it. It was so pretty, like, and there are just so many like cool references in it that, you know, when like they reference like artistic or literary things in books, and even if you like only vaguely know it, it just makes you feel smart for like being able to recognize. I think this was one of those books. It was one of those ones that doesn't really have like a huge plot. It's more of a slow burn kind of like, you enjoy the art of storytelling books rather than like action, action, action. But yeah, I really enjoyed this one. The next one was actually one that I was supposed to read in school but didn't. But then I got to it this year and I loved it. And it's Do Not Say We Have Nothing. This was, again, a really unique story and was just like a masterclass on writing. Like the writing and like how the plots were all weaved together was just so cool, that if you are a writer or if you just love literature, you should definitely check this out. And it was a cool like intergenerational like aspect of it too. And yeah, it talks about like just really interesting stuff and is definitely an ode to storytelling. So yeah, can't say enough about this book. The next one is kind of different because it's a memoir, and it's called Heartberries. And I remember this was so sad. Like, I feel like you definitely have to be in a good headspace to read this, because otherwise it'll just send you into a tailspin. But yeah, it was just so beautifully written and so many important topics touched upon, and just yeah, it was one of those ones where I couldn't put it down, but really sad. So definitely a lot of warnings for this book. If you're going through some stuff, maybe not the right read for you, but yeah, it was really great, so I would definitely recommend. Okay, the next one is a bit of a like controversial pick, because I don't like the author, but the book was just so good that I felt guilty for like not including it on this list, and that's The House in the Cerulean Sea. I know the author has said some really messed up things about like the 60s scoop and that kind of stuff, so I'm not a fan of that. I just would like to put that out there. But this book, like, it makes me feel so guilty for liking it because this is such an amazing book. Like, I think it was one of my favorite books I read this year because it's just so wholesome and magical, but not in like a childish way. Like, it was just like, it felt like it was like a hug. I don't know, when you're reading this book, like, it's hard to describe, but, and I know that there was so much hype around this book too, and like, the book itself truly deserves it. The author sucks, but the book itself is really great, so it's kind of like a weird space to be in. But this is just such a memorable story, and like, I think about it like pretty often, so I just felt like I had to include it in this list. But yeah, it's a great story, and it kind of brought out the like childlike wonder without being a kid's book, if that makes sense. But ooh, the next book was again so good, and it's Return of the Trickster. This was the third installment of the Trickster series, so I was so sad that the series was ending, but I was really happy because I thought the book wrapped it up pretty well. I just want the best for Jared. He's such a wholesome character, and I feel like it ended like pretty well. I was satisfied with it. But yeah, if you haven't read them, the Trickster series, the first one is called Son of a Trickster, is actually amazing. Eden Robinson is a fabulous writer, and I really loved the whole series. So sad that it's over, but I can't wait to see what else she comes up with. This one was the most recent book I've read, but I ended up really enjoying it. And that's The Paper Palace. I think if you have read Where the Crawdads Sing, which was like a hugely popular book, I think they're making it into a TV show. But if you've read that book, I think you will really like this one because it gave me kind of similar vibes. Even though the stories themselves aren't, like the plots aren't that similar, I just had like a similar feeling while reading it. Like, it's kind of like isolation with, this is like mainly set at like a cabin. I actually don't know where the cabin is. Like, I think somewhere in, oh, Cape Cod. Yeah, so I don't know, it's just a very like summery vibe, and it was really good. I would definitely put like a few trauma warnings on this, but I really liked the way that the narrative was weaved through, and there was kind of like a love triangle in it, which was fun. But yeah, it was a good read, pretty quick read. But I'd be interested to read more of this author's work. And yeah, if you liked Where the Crawdads Sing, definitely check this one out. The next one is Concrete Rose. And I loved this book. I love Angie Thomas, like, as an author. She's a really cool person, too. I follow her on Twitter. She just got a dog. But yeah, this was such a good book. And I, like, loved the writing style in this. I feel like she really did a good job with the dialogue and trying to make it realistic. And just, it was cool to see, like, because this book is, like, sort of tied to The Hate U Give, whereas in, I'm pretty sure, it follows her father, is a main character, and it's just, yeah, it just was a really fun and cool read, and talked about, obviously, like, very serious topics, but still, like, but they didn't, that wasn't the main thing of it. Like, it was just, I don't know how to describe it, it was just a really fun read, but also, like, has that poignant moments in it to balance out. And yeah, I thought she did, I mean, obviously, yeah, I'm not a 17-year-old guy, but I feel like she did a pretty good job at, like, trying to emulate a male voice in it, because I know that's sometimes hard to do when you're a female writer. But yeah, it was just a really great book, and I really want to see more of her stuff. I don't actually know if this came out this year. I kind of think it did, but it's pretty one of her, like, more recent ones, I think. But yeah. Okay, the next one is I think one of my top favorite ones of this year, and that is The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. I know that literally everyone talks about this book, but it's for a good reason. And it's by the same author who did Daisy Jones and the Six, which I talked about earlier. And I love this one too. I actually read this one first. And yeah, it was just such a gripping story. The characters were so beautifully fleshed out. And yeah, it's just a really cool book. I definitely recommend. I personally think I may like Daisy Jones and the Six slightly more, but they're both like easy 5-star reads, so you can't go wrong with either. But yeah, I would definitely recommend this. Okay, the last physical book that I have here with me that I'm going to talk about today is Ninth House by Leigh Bardugo. And I really enjoyed this book. I know this, again, was another one for, like, people who are a fan of this author and, like, have read, like, the Shadow and Bone ones. I heard that they didn't like this as much, which I found interesting. But because this is more of, like, an adult fantasy, and when I read it, I was under the impression that it was a standalone. But I'm pretty sure it's not because the ending was left so ambiguous that I think they're doing more. And I hope they're doing more because I really enjoyed this. This was another one that was kind of like dark academia vibes with like a little like fantasy and murder mystery, and also too like had lots of like literary references in it, I think. Actually, I can't remember if they did. I think they did. But it's cool because it's like set at Yale and it's about like college students and that kind of thing, which is nice because like that's sort of in the era that I'm at, I guess. Not really, but because I'm still doing education but not undergrad anymore. But yeah, this was really good, and I feel like because I'm not super into fantasy, like this was a good like little tester of it. But yeah, really enjoyed this. So if you like fantasy and you like dark academia, I think you would like this book. Okay, then I have a little list of the other ones that I wanted to mention but I don't have here with me. I don't know what I did with them. I either lent them to someone or they've just like disappeared in my house. But yeah, so the first one is Writers and Lovers. If I can, I'll try and like stick a picture of it up here. I don't know if I know how to do that, so we might just have to put it in the description box. But Writers and Lovers was just, it was so good. It was, I'm pretty sure I gave it 5 stars. But yeah, it was just about writing and loss and relationships, and I feel like if you like writing, you should definitely read this book. I feel like it's kind of an essential for all aspiring writers. But yeah, I really enjoyed that. What else is on here? The next one was Hannah Khan Carries On. And I loved that book. It was so cute. Like, I normally don't read a whole lot of romance books, but I tried this one out because I saw it was by a Canadian author, and obviously want to support Canadian authors. And I loved it. I feel like it was so fun, so uplifting, but also too had like some moments where it talked about like real issues, and I thought that it was handled really well. Like, especially like for a romance book, which doesn't usually tackle heavy stuff like that. But yeah, it was just really good. And I just got one of the author's other books for Christmas, so I'm really excited to read more of their stuff in the new year. Then the next one was, that I don't have with me, is The Silent Patient. That was really good. I don't usually read a whole lot of like murder mystery kind of ones, or I guess thriller. I don't know if it would be qualified as that, but yeah, I really enjoyed that one. I didn't see the twist at the end coming, so that was pretty good. But yeah, definitely an enjoyable read. And then the last book that was in my favorites of 2021, which is crazy to think that we're like gonna be in 2022 in like a day, but anyways, was The Poet X. I believe it's by Elizabeth Acevedo. And I read that as an ebook, because I had to read it for school, actually. And I was like, my mind was blown while reading it. Like, seriously, I cannot wait to read more of their work because, like, it was so amazing. And I really highly encourage people to read it. But it was just so cool because it was like a whole book, like, written in like prose poetry style, which normally I would hate. I would be the first to admit I'm not a huge poetry person, but the way that this was done was just so flawless and like just like, I don't know, you could just like feel it in you, like, as you were reading it, like, and it was just like so many emotional like pieces of it too, and like the writing was just, again, just beautiful. So yeah, I can't recommend The Poet X enough. That was probably one of my other top favorite reads. But anyways, that is the end of my favorite books. There were lots of other books this year that I liked, but I didn't want this video to be like super long. And books that I liked but maybe weren't favorites. But yeah, these are just some awesome books, and hopefully if you watch this, you check them out, because yeah, they deserve some recognition. I mean, some of them already get a lot of recognition, but yeah. Anyways, thanks so much for watching. I probably won't be making more videos anytime soon because I'm going back to school soon. But yeah, we'll see. Who knows? Anyways, hope that everyone has a good 2022. Bye.